So, Mark, what is your favorite hobby?
Probably sports.
Anything specific or just sports in general?
Most sports. I like basketball, football, baseball, golf, tennis. So I guess most sports.
I like tennis. Did you play for your high school team?
Yeah, I played on the varsity team starting from my sophomore year. How about you?
I played my junior and senior year.
What other sports did you play?
I played volleyball. I would have to say volleyball is my favorite.
What position did you play?
I was the outside hitter.
That's so cool. I didn't know you were athletic.
I don't know if I would consider myself athletic, but I have fun playing.
I play on a co-ed volleyball team every Tuesday. We are always looking for more girls to play on our team. Would you be interested?
Yeah, it sounds fun. Just call me anytime you need a player.
That's great. Since we're on the topic of sports, what sport do you like to watch on television?
I never got into watching sports on TV, so I really don't know.
Not even the Super Bowl?
Only when the group of people I'm with is watching it. I just never had interest in TV that much.
Well, I like following the Mariners. They are pretty good.
I like to go watch them play. It's fun when you are actually there.
A bunch of us are going to watch them play this June. Do you want to join us?
Yeah, I'll go. I like the new stadium. It's pretty cool.
Okay. I'll make sure to get you a ticket as well.
Fit in all your work and do not slack, or it will be the worse for you. Get back to work.
Coppers, boiler, sand and soap. You'll get used to it.
Good morning, madam.
Don't speak till you're spoken to.
Yes, madam.
Go in. Disturb nothing. Leave all just as it is.
I'm sorry, sir.
Shh. Stay. Your master is a fine painter, Grit. Look at that dress. You can almost stroke the satin. He had a vision.
Look at the clouds. What color are they?
No one saw as clearly as she.
Yellow, blue, and gray.
Master Van Ryphon, your name will surely be famed as one of the great patrons.
I want something I can rest my eyes on.
How hard is it to paint a pretty girl?
Can I have her?
Sir, do not ask this of me.
In a house where everyone had their place.
Tomorrow morning.
I have work.
Find a way.
Where every image had meaning.
Take off your cap.
He gave her the power to see the light.
To get caught up in his world.
I would never give in to Master Van Ryphon.
I wasn't talking about Van Ryphon.
She gave him a look that would last forever.
Open your mouth.
I hear you've been of great use to your master, all that grinding and stirring, eh?
She's dishonest, always sneaking around, shirking her work.
Now lick your lips.
Tell me how you get on up there. Do you move him? Do you inspire him?
Lionsgate Films presents Colin Firth, Scarlett Johansson, Tom Wilkinson in The Mystery Behind the Masterpiece. Girl with a Pearl Earring.
Britain's most afraid of heights and snakes. This is BreakingNewsEnglish.com. A new survey from an internet-based market research company shows the things British people are most afraid of. Top of the list is heights. Over half of the people who took the survey said they had acrophobia, the medical name for the fear of heights. In second place was a fear of snakes, with 21% of people saying they were very afraid of the slippery creatures. The third biggest fear was public speaking, with 20% being very afraid and 36% being a little afraid of speaking in public. Other things that frighten people most include spiders, mice, needles and injections, the sight of blood, flying, and being in small spaces. Number 10 on the list was coulrophobia, the fear of clowns. The market research company asked over 2,000 people what they were afraid of. They had to rate 13 common phobias, from not at all afraid to very afraid. The researchers found that there were big differences between what men and women were afraid of, and what frightened old and young people. The researchers said, all are not created equal when it comes to fears. The survey showed that more women than men were afraid of things, especially spiders. These scare a third of men and about half of women. Age differences showed young people were more likely to be afraid of public speaking. Those in the older age groups were more likely than younger people to be afraid of heights.
Good morning, British Council.
Hello, may I speak to Ms. Proctor?
I'm sorry, she is not in. Can I take a message?
Yes, please. This is Mr. Kale.
Is that G-A-L-E?
No, it's K-A-L-E.
Thank you.
Please tell her the meeting is on Tuesday at 9:30 in room 214.
Tuesday at 9:30 in room 214.
And would you ask her to call me this afternoon to confirm this? My number is
541-3099. 541-3099. Yes, Mr. Kale, I will give Ms. Proctor the message.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good afternoon. 651-8935.
Hello, could I speak to Wendy?
I'm afraid she is not in right now. Can I take a message?
Yes, there is a party at Bob's house on Sunday night. Bob's address is flat 4, 45 Church Road.
Bob's address is flat 4, 45 Church Road.
And could you tell her that if she is interested to call me back this evening? My telephone number is 361-3759.
Your number is 361-3759. All right. Sorry, who is calling?
Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Sandy Paris.
Sandy Paris. Fine. I'll give her the message. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hi, Michelle. This is Sam. Can I speak with Ben?
Hi, Sam. No, I'm sorry. He's not home right now.
Do you know when he'll be back?
He's gonna be out for several hours. Do you want to leave a message?
Yeah, thanks. I'm supposed to meet Ben at Cafe Joan for lunch at noon tomorrow, but I have a doctor's appointment, so I'm gonna be a few minutes late.
Do you know what time you're gonna be there?
I'll try to get there as soon as I can. I should be there by 12:30.
Hi, I'm Emily, and today I'm going to show you around the University of Sydney. There's a lot of history here at the uni, and you can't help but feel part of something bigger when you step on campus. One of the things that I really like about the university is the sense of community that exists here, and I think it's the grounds and the space that really allows that. Students used to play tennis in the middle of the quad right here. Today, this space and the surrounding lawns are a place for teaching, events, lots of great photo opportunities, and of course, hanging out with friends. You can see why this whole place is known as the Oxford of the Southern Hemisphere. And this is the Great Hall, the first and last stop for a lot of students, where we have graduations and welcome new students from overseas. If you look up, you'll see 12 carved wooden angels. They're carrying books and scrolls inscribed with symbols referring to the arts and sciences. There's a lot more history here, like this. This is the Anderson Stewart Building, formerly known as the Old Medical School. This building is home to the university's first human dissection labs. Since then, our network of clinical schools has grown to include 10 major metropolitan and rural teaching hospitals. And it's not just health and medicine with campuses all around. About 70 kilometres that way, you'll find our Camden Farms. Aside from agriculture and vet students getting hands-on with plants, crops and animals, you'll see plenty of wildlife with regular visits from the locals. The uni has 18 farms in New South Wales, spanning over 12,000 hectares. The university's Westmead campus will open its new education and clinical facilities in 2021. In all these places, health students will get to be in real-life clinical settings from their first year. And then there's this. This is the Susan Wakel building. It brings together all the health disciplines under the one roof. Inside, there are brand new simulation facilities, a multi-service clinic, and a rehabilitation gym, as well as teaching, research, and support spaces. Speaking of gym spaces, there's no end of sports facilities at the uni. There's the Sports and Aquatic Centre, an indoor climbing centre, tennis courts and squash courts. Any type of sport goes on here, including, of course, Quidditch. The university's facilities are one of the best things about studying here, especially places like this, the Abercrombie Building, one of my favourite study spots and home to our business school. The views of Sydney at the top are also pretty cool.
I find my experience studying at UCL very engaging and rewarding. I get to meet people from all over the world and make friends with them. For myself, learning on campus really motivates me to find the areas I'm truly passionate about.
Here's Sydney College of the Arts' brand new facilities. It has traditional fine arts and crafts, film and digital labs. You can create almost anything here, both physical and virtual. Then there's the new multi-purpose social sciences building. Near the social sciences building is Courtyard Cafe. It's a great place to have a drink and catch up with some friends. There's no end to great cafes and shops around campus. And you get to Courtyard Cafe via the legendary graffiti tunnel and a place for creative expression. You can spray paint, write slogans, and create street art. It's a UCL student's rite of passage.
Good afternoon, passengers. This is the pre-boarding announcement for flight 89B to Rome. We are now inviting those passengers with small children and any passengers requiring special assistance to begin boarding at this time. Please have your boarding pass and identification ready. Regular boarding will begin in approximately 10 minutes' time. Thank you. Good afternoon, passengers. This is your captain speaking. First, I'd like to welcome everyone on right wing flight 86A. We are currently cruising at an altitude of 33,000 feet at an airspeed of 400 miles per hour. The time is 1:25 p.m. The weather looks good, and with a tailwind on our side, we are expecting to land in London approximately 15 minutes ahead of schedule. The weather in London is clear and sunny, with a high of 25 degrees for this afternoon. If the weather cooperates, we should get a great view of the city as we descend. The cabin crew will be coming around in about 20 minutes' time to offer you a light snack and beverage, and the in-flight movie will begin shortly after that. I'll talk to you again before we reach our destination. Until then, sit back, relax, and enjoy the rest of the flight.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Asiana Airlines, we'd like to welcome you on board flight 532, bound for London Heathrow. The captain of this flight is Captain Letts, and this is your steward, Alan Chandler. Our flight time to London Heathrow will be 12 hours, 30 minutes following takeoff. At this time, please make sure that your seatbelt is fastened, and we recommend that you continue to wear your seatbelt while seated should we experience unexpected turbulence. We would like to remind you that smoking in the cabin and lavatories is not permitted at any time throughout the flight. In a few moments, I will be showing a short video on the safety aspects of this aircraft. Please watch and listen carefully.
Okay, may I see your driver's license, please?
What? Did I do anything wrong?
License, please, and your car registration.
Oh, yeah. It's somewhere here in the glove compartment. Yeah, here it is.
Sir, did you realize you were speeding in a school zone?
What? No, I didn't. That's probably because my odometer is broken. Malfunctioning.
Yes, you were going 50 miles per hour in a 20 miles per hour zone, and...
What?
And you failed to come to a complete stop at the intersection back there.
Rolling stops don't count?
And one of your brake lights is out. And you're not wearing a seatbelt. And your driver's license expired 6 months ago.
And your name is... Officer Smith.
Yeah.
Hey, are you related to the Smiths in town?
Well...
My wife's cousin's husband, I think his name is Fred, works for the police department here. Or was that the fire department? Anyway, I thought you might be good pals and, you know...
Hey, are you trying to influence an officer? I could have this car impounded right here because of these infractions.
No, of course not.
Okay, then. Here's your ticket. You can either appear in court to pay the fine or mail it in. And have a nice day.
You take cash?